Ryder Family Stadium on Senior Day. The final Big 12 game of the season pits West Virginia and Kansas State trying to become bowl eligible with these back-to-back wins. West Virginia rolling as well. And we say welcome inside. Joe Davis with Brady Quinn. Chris Budden joins us in just a moment. Really, both these teams, Brady, have been up and down this year. Those good starts to the season, but then mid-season losing streaks. They've recovered to get things going again. Some streaks coming into this game, making it meaningful. And in the case of Kansas State, it's pretty clear what's up for grabs today. That is bowl eligibility.
Yeah, bowl eligibility, but really it would have been there probably either way. What's up for grabs is the possibility of a winning season, in particular for a senior class that has been pretty successful here at Kansas State. And obviously the uncertainty around head coach Bill Snyder and if indeed this will be his last season coaching.
They got things going with that come from behind win against Iowa State a couple of weeks ago. Got a win last week in the Governor's Cup game. And coming to this one against his West Virginia team that won three in a row against a pretty easy non-conference slate. Then that gauntlet in October where they went 0-4. They've now won four straight and a chance to get to 8 wins today.
And they've won four straight running the football, which is a little bit of a mix-up for Dana Holgorsen, who's part of that air raid coaching system. But West Virginia now has a ground attack that's tough to stop. We'll see if Kansas State can do it today.
And down on the field, Chris Budden.
Thanks so much, Joe. There are a ton of emotions surrounding Bill Snyder in this entire weekend. To start with, he has not decided if he will retire. He'll make that decision at the end of the season. It's also Senior Day. He's honoring 18 seniors. He told me earlier today to deal with all of that. He goes through a rehearsal with all the seniors so that they can put the emotion aside and focus on today's game. Also on Tuesday, it will be Snyder getting the honor as he will be inducted into the College Football Hall of Fame. Get this, he will just be the fourth coach to be inducted while still coaching. But in talking to Coach Snyder, the 76-year-old has one thing on his mind today, that's getting his team to 6-6 and securing a bowl bid, Joe.
Yeah, I think the only way you turn the thing around the way he has here at Kansas State is by taking it a day at a time. It might be coach speak, but it's what he's done. Dana Holgorsen has beaten everybody in the Big 12 besides Oklahoma and Kansas State. K-State won the toss, deferred to the second half. Gary Jennings back for West Virginia. Ian Patterson sends it away, and off we go from Manhattan. Javon Durant backs into the end zone. West Virginia will get things going from the 25-yard line. Relied more and more on the run game. 70% of the time in Big 12 wins. What are we watching for?
Oh, that's the thing. It's really this West Virginia offense flipping the script during their run streak. And they've gotten away from the pass more and incorporated Skylar Howard and Wendell Smallwood, is really one of the top rushing attacks in the Big 12. And then on defense, they're going up against one of the top defenses against the run, highlighted by defensive end Jordan Willis. 13 tackles for a loss. He's going to have an impact in this game.
Yeah, K-State defense number 3 in the Big 12 in rush D. Wendell Smallwood with a first down run. And a good way to start it for the number 2 running back in the Big 12. More than 1,300 yards this season.
And whenever you see Smallwood cap off some of these big runs, it's in part because of the blocking downfield by their wide receivers.
They motion Smallwood out. First throw of the day for Skylar Howard will come at a later moment as he's dropped for a loss of 2 by Marquell Bryant, one of the seniors celebrating on this Senior Day. Second down.
Yeah, Bryant's one of the more speed rush ends that's going to come off and eventually get pressure, but really it was the coverage by the Kansas State defense. No one open downfield.
Back to the ground, and Smallwood with a seam up to the 44 with a stop from Adams and Jackson at safety. His third down and about 2 on West Virginia's first drive. Third down and 14. Howard throwing, has a completion to Shelton Gibson, but he's quickly tossed down by Duke Shelley. about 4 yards short of the mark, the 46.
And Shelton Gibson's really the game breaker for West Virginia. It seems like when they can get a lot of production out of him, that's when they have their biggest games passing the football. You go look back a week ago, 6 receptions, 148 yards, and a touchdown. The rest of the team, only 6 catches for 54 yards. So you can see what a kind of impact he has.
O'Toole had that one partially blocked. And it dies inside the 20. Second week in a row, Kansas State has gotten the one. And is it Morgan Burns involved again?
I don't think it'd be possible for him to get 4 weeks in a row the Big 12 Special Team Player of the Week after having 2 kick returns for touchdowns. Last week, a blocked punt recovered in the end zone for a touchdown. He's been incredibly impressive and just disruptive in the special teams game.
Bill Snyder told us he takes a great deal of pride in special teams. Most of the guys that come through this program do. So Kansas State begins its first drive at the 18-yard line. O'Toole got a pretty fortuitous bounce after that ball was partially blocked. And this Kansas State offense coming off its most productive 3-game stretch of the season. And Joe Huebner at quarterback, junior out of Cheney, Kansas. We'll start the game with a straight drop and a ball that's tipped and incomplete. Nick Kwiatkowski got his hand on it.
Well, that's going to be the struggle for Joe Huebner today, is going up against one of the best pass defenses in the Big 12 with West Virginia. They do an incredible job of not only coverage downfield, but really being able to get turnovers as well.
21 interceptions this season. They're third in the country in takeaways. They're one of the worst teams in the country in takeaways last year. They load up the box on second down and 10. Kansas State tries to run into it, but nothing doing. Noble Wachuku shutting down Charles Jones and making it third down and long, giving us a chance to take a look at what we're watching for.
Well, it's going to be that risk-reward. Joe Huebner's got to be able to take care of the football when he takes his shots downfield because of how effective West Virginia's pass defense is. And you look at this West Virginia team, there's no quit. I mean, when you look at the way they've played through their losing streak down the winning streak, they continue to give effort and continue to make big plays.
See what you did there. Nick Kwiatkowski's name, well done. You and Kevin Word down in our graphics department. First third down of the day, and Huebner has Deontay Burton for a Kansas State first down. Up to the 46 on a gain of 28.
That's the kind of patience that Joe Huebner is going to have. Watch as we get Deontay Burton up into a deep dig route. He's able to find the open space. Nice little passing route combination by co-offensive coordinator Dana Dimmel. Going to get Joe Huebner going early on in the game.
Burton having his best season. Good numbers there for him. Over his first 2 years, he only had 17 catches total. Both Gronkowski and Dimmel. On first down from the 43, they both lead the way for Huebner, who has a short gain. Christian Brown with a stop. And it's second down and 8.
You look at this defensive front for West Virginia. They play a 3-down front. You only got 3 of those big boys up there, and they try to take up offensive linemen so guys like Jared Barber and Nick Kwiatkowski can run around and make plays. So Christian Brown on the last play, but Kyle Rose, the nose tackle, number 93, he's a guy that has tremendous production from that position.
Which is not something you usually associate with the nose. I mean, Coach Gibson told us this week that he thinks Rose is probably the most productive nose that he's seen in his 2 decades coaching. Huebner to throw on second down, taking a shot into traffic and incomplete. Wanted Cody Cook. Darrell Chestnut jarred out of there, and it's third down.
Well, they're running a 3-level combination for Kansas State, meaning they've got a guy low, I got a guy in the middle, and I got a guy deep. Huebner tries to fit this ball in, but Chestnut wasn't fooled. As you can see, K.J. Dillon being able to get in as well. It was a tight window.
Worst third down team in the Big 12. Third down and 8. West Virginia bringing pressure. It's picked up, so Huebner with time. And one-on-one, incomplete. Had what he wanted out there. Burton against Chestnut. It sailed way over his head, and it's fourth down.
Well, this is a fingerprint of defensive coordinator Tony Gibson. Look at the disguise. Doesn't necessarily look like anyone's coming, but all those guys in that circle are going to be coming after Joe Huebner. The offensive line does just good enough job being able to block up, protect, and give Huebner a chance to take a shot downfield to Burton.
Punting with the wind, Nick Walsh didn't get it very well and downed inside the 40. 46-yard punt. West Virginia will have it, but who will be a quarterback for him? Skyler Howard right now is running back onto the field. Just FYI, as we get ready to go to this break, K-State and West Virginia rolls on in a moment. So we'll see how he is. Already dealing with that right hand and wrist injury from a few weeks ago. And now right ankle bothering him. First down and 10 from the 37. Russell Shell for a gain of 5 on first down behind this offensive line that's gotten Adam Pankey back, and that's big in left guard.
Yeah, when talking to Danner Holgerson before the game, he said, we had Stone Underwood in there last week. It'd be a big help if we get Adam Pankey back.
Shell again pushed out of bounds close to the marker by Kendall Adams. And looks like it is enough.
And he's important when talking about Pankey in particular because they are so tough up front. We were talking about Kansas State, and that's why they're one of the top teams versus the rush in the Big 12. And he's got a tough load with Britz and Geary playing across from him.
Quarterback draw, Howard with room, and he slides down. Nice first down gain to continue to work it on the ground.
It's been interesting just watching this start of the game so far for West Virginia, their play selection. Coming into this game, they're very, very run heavy. They've kind of opened it up a bit early, at least not so much of what they've done over the past few weeks during this win streak.
And the numbers right now today are skewed some because of a couple of sacks. There's a strike to Javon Durant. His first catch in the last three games. Both running backs in the game on first down. Smallwood spinning his way through a tackle for a first down gain of 5. Right now, West Virginia is doing what it's done over the last four games or so, and that is have success mostly on the ground.
Dana Holgerson keeps it simple. He says, if it works, run it again. If not, run something else.
Bubbling to Shell. We got a block on the edge from Shorts. Stuffed his shoulder down to near the first down mark. Kendall Adams made the tackle, third and one.
West Virginia puts so much pressure on you as a defense because of how fast they play. They'll slow down every once in a while, in particular on third down, to ensure they get the right call and they get in the right position to be able to convert.
K-State loads up the box on third and one. Shell stop and start and go down for a loss of 3. Jordan Willis and Will Geary combine into the tackle and it's fourth down.
We talked about it before the game. Watch the defensive front for Kansas State. Look at the penetration. You get Will Geary able to get a hand in on him. Jordan Willis comes at the end to finish him off. And West Virginia offensive line, it's not much I can do about that.
No. So they bring the field goal team out. And again, this shot will be into the wind.
36, Josh Lambert.
From 45 yards for Josh Lambert. Lambert hooks it in to begin the scoring. Junior from Garland, Texas, who hasn't had quite the season he had last year when he led the country with 30 makes. This one good from 45 and late in the first quarter. 3-0 West Virginia. FS1 College Football is presented by K Jewelers. They continue to look at Skyler Howard back through that crowd. In a 3-0 game here in Manhattan. Short kick. Dominic Heath was playing one of the up men, so he's got it. Back to the 16-yard line. Huebner throwing for Cook. Started to shuffle towards the line of scrimmage to draw the backers up and open up a window.
Yeah, Joe Huebner is such an integral part of this rush or offense for Kansas State. Look how he's patient. Allows Cody Cook to get back behind Nick Kwiatkowski for West Virginia and find the opening. what makes Kansas State so tough to prepare for is when they have a quarterback that's also part of that running game. You got to account for him as well.
Tony Gibson, D coordinator for West Virginia, told us that K-State is by far the hardest team in the conference to prepare for. Justin Sillman comes into the game at running back. Into pass protect as they go to Burton for his second reception, and he submarines forward for 6 or 7.
Well, part of the reason why they're so hard to prepare for is the fact that they do a variety of things. You see right there, they can hit you with the quick passing game, where at times they'll bring in multiple fullbacks and they'll pound away at the running game, or sometimes they'll bring in 3 wide receivers and 1 tight end. They'll spread you out and then pass as well. So a lot of different things that you've got to prepare for and practice for when you play Kansas State.
4 wide outs, 1 running back in there for 2nd down and 3. The running back is Charles Jones. Huger making a late change. 5 to snap it. Catch and throw too high for Kyle Klein, who did not play last week because of an injury. That ball missed him, and it's 3rd down.
This is where the West Virginia defense has been particularly tough on 3rd down, and they've been able to get pressure on quarterbacks in part because they show you a variety of looks. Tony Gibson's going to give you all these guys up around the line of scrimmage threatening the blitz. Sometimes they come, sometimes they don't. And it's incredibly difficult for a quarterback to discern and then get his eyes back downfield for his read.
Under center for 3rd down and 3. Outside, they flip it, and a great job to stay home by Jeremy Tyler. And it is 4th down. And so Nick O'Toole, who during warm-ups today hit 176 yards with a wind at his back like he'll have to begin the 2nd quarter. Kansas State trying to finish the regular season with a 3-game winning streak. West Virginia trying to finish it with a 5-game winning streak. Busy day for Nick Walsh. Ready to punt it on a beautiful day in early December. Sophomore from Linden, Kansas, just got rid of that one. Line drive to Gary Jennings, who loses the football, and Kansas State is on it. This time, special team swings in K-State's favor because of a West Virginia mistake. 1st down in West Virginia territory.
One of the hardest things to do as a punt returner is try to have to run up and field the football. And true freshman Gary Jennings had to run up to actually field this. And on his way, his momentum took him into the football a little bit too much. It hit off his chest. He couldn't quite field it cleanly. And therein lies the opportunity for Kansas State. That's really been the problem for West Virginia this season. It's been penalties, untimely turnovers, and really lack of execution.
A lot of times you'll see teams take shots in this situation. Is that what K-State will do? Huebner lofting Bimmel, 1st down inside the 25. First time we've seen the fullback utilized in the passing game, and it goes for 28.
Offensive coordinator Dana Dimmel dialing one up for his son Winston as he runs up the seam. Nick Kwiatkowski doesn't get his eyes back on Dimmel and get back into coverage. Instead, Dimmel's able to run up the seam for the big play.
Proud dad right there. 2nd week in a row, long reception for his son. Gronkowski now in at fullback in front of Charles Jones. Straight downhill they go, but Jones looking to bounce. Chestnut shut him down. And a gain of 1, 2nd and 9.
And we're starting to see again these fullbacks come back into the game as Dimmel checks back in the game and Gronkowski checks out. But that's where Kansas State has had more effect, is bringing in these guys where they can utilize some of the play action pass, which we just saw a moment ago. It's very tough to defend when you've got these capable fullbacks who are really good, not only pass protection, but run blocking, but then can also catch the ball out of the backfield.
And a lot of those play action passes coming down the field. You saw a moment ago, 14 yards per completion for Huebner. That puts him in the top 15 in the country. Option play. He'll cut it off. Nowhere to go. Stacked up by Christian Brown. lost a couple, and it's third down and long for Kansas State.
Christian Brown, the redshirt junior out of Dunbar High School in Fort Myers, Florida, he's having himself a game on Boston Syverson, the left guard for Kansas State so far today.
It's an old line for K-State that brought back four starters from last year, but they've dealt with injuries across the board. Stuyvesant, one of the guys that has had to battle through some. Third down and 12, and out of an empty set, they get pressure, and Huebner throws it away. Tony Gibson dials it up. Shaq Pettaway forced the errant throw.
This is what's so difficult preparing for him. Look at all the guys up around line of scrimmage. This means they're going to get to the quarterback quick because one of these guys is going to be unaccounted for in the pass protection. To see both Shaq Pettaway and Nick Kwiatkowski were able to get to Joe Huebner. It's incredibly difficult trying to prepare for Tony Gibson because he brings everyone sometimes,
yeah,
and then he puts them up around line of scrimmage like that and then drops them all. It's tough as a quarterback to prepare and be able to see everything clearly throughout the course of the game.
Matthew McCrane is in to kick. That means something's still wrong with Jack Cantelli. And McCrane drills it from 40 to even the issue at three. He's been hurt most of the season. A lot of this team has. But he's back in the fold. Tying the game, K-State and West Virginia. Back in a moment. Beautiful day here in Manhattan. So if you want to go take that run, it's a good day for it. Joe Davis, Brady Quinn, Chris Butt, Mike Pereira, a rules expert. Tied at three in what has been a defensive battle here in the Big 12 finale. Ian Patterson with a wobbler that bounces awkwardly off of Durant's hands. Crushed at the 15-yard line. Trent Taking with a special teams tackle. From the 16-yard line, pressure coming against West Virginia on first down, and Smallwood stacked up. That's Elijah Lee, their leading tackler, coming up with a stop. Sophomore out of Blue Springs, Missouri. Nice future for this guy.
Oh, very, very bright future for Elijah Lee. I mean, all over the fields making plays, and it's, again, been in part because of the defensive front he has in front of him.
Oh, blown coverage, and Durant dropped it. That kind of year for the freshman.
Yeah, defensive coordinator Tom Hayes dials up a corner blitz. Watch as Morgan Burns comes off the edge. I'm not sure what exactly they're trying to do, and Kendall Adams didn't get over in time for coverage, but missed opportunity for West Virginia's. Javon Durant can't bring the football in.
It was as if Burns was the only one that knew the corner blitz was on. Likely would have been a touchdown with Durant's speed. Instead, third and long. It's Thompson getting crunched, but getting a first down. Nate Jackson makes the tackle. Thompson's had a quiet year, but a big catch here to keep the drive going.
There's that matchup in around the middle of the field. Whether it's Jordan Thompson, number 10, or Dakeel Shorts, both are being utilized in those quick slant patterns in the middle of the field.
That ball's thrown with authority back to Thompson, a 5'7 senior with another first down.
You know, Joe, we were down on the field before the game. The wind is incredibly heavy going from right to left on the screen. So if this is the part of the, this is the direction of the field in which you'd want to throw the football more.
West Virginia back at it. Here comes Russell Schell. And again, Shermichael Moore runs him down already with his sixth tackle. Good start to this game for Moore. Schell gets one, second and nine. Missed most of last year with an injury, did Moore. He's helped this defense get off to a good start in this game. Howard scans, throws well behind Shelton Gibson. Those two right now are not feeling each other.
Yeah, this passing offense for West Virginia is just out of rhythm. And it hasn't really been the case earlier in the season. They won three in a row, but then once they started to go through that gauntlet in the Big 12, they struggled, and that actually carried into their four-game winning streak, and that's really they've been most successful running the football, not passing.
Which goes against what Dana Holgorsen is known for. Third down and nine. Pressure comes, got rid of it, broke it up. David Sills couldn't hang on, and it was Morgan Burns with the coverage. Fourth down.
Defensive coordinator Tom Hayes dials up something out of Tony Gibson's playbook. An all-out blitz, forcing Skylar Howard to have to get the ball out of his hand quick. And once again, West Virginia struggling to convert on third down, and that's really a product of them not having as much success on first and second in that particular drive, and so far in the first half.
O'Toole punts it away. Dominique Heath goes back to his own five to catch it. And Shelton Gibson may be having a hard time on offense today, but a nice special teams play to drop him inside the five. That's a cardinal sin right there on a ball. Ticketed for the end zone. Heath goes back and grabs it. Pays the price. This is the sixth K-State drive that has begun inside its own 20.
Look at all the guys around the line of scrimmage.
Forcing Huebner, daring Huebner to throw, but instead he'll run and get thrown down for a loss by Noble Wachuku, is having a heck of a game here in the regular season finale.
And this is where defenses start to smell blood, and they really start to become more aggressive up front in particular. Look at Wachuku just be able to break through Cody Small. Cody Small has had a rough time today trying to block some of this defensive front for West Virginia. Wachuku, the leading sack artist on this West Virginia front.
It's the fourth tackle for loss for this West Virginia defense, who again puts 10 men right up at the line of scrimmage. Huebner was dared, and he'll launch it. Worley goes up, juggles, and makes the catch for an interception. Darryl Worley with his sixth pick of the season, and back-to-back drives ended by this secondary.
You can see Worley at the top of your screen. They're going to run a deep post route, and Joe Huebner underthrows this football. Burton had a step on Worley, but if you give Darryl Worley an opportunity to get a hand on the football, he's coming away with it. Said it's six interceptions on the season. He had an amazing one last week, really, where he leaped up and just snagged the ball out of the air. The junior out of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, an incredible athlete, probably their best corner, too, when you flick on the tape and watch him go after it. Opposing wide receivers.
Can West Virginia's offense take advantage? Great field position after the interception. Smallwood with room. And seven on first down. Tanner Wood, Shemichael Moore combining in the tackle, second and three. We line inside of 4 minutes in this opening half. Smallwood again. Moore again with the tackle, playing one of his best games of the season. They spot him short. Third and less than a yard for the Mountaineers.
Shemichael Moore is the other linebacker in that group that really does a good job of relying on his instincts. He reads his keys, and once he sees there's a hole, he's filling it right away. He's having a big game so far today.
Elijah Wellman, the fullback, in to help clear the way for a first down run from Smallwood. Three consecutive carries for the junior from Wilmington, Delaware, who quietly has racked up 74 yards on 12 touches in this first half.
He's really a complete back when you look at his ability to hit the home runs once he gets to the outside, but also make the tough runs like we saw in that last snap.
Howard comes to his second read and has a wide open Durant, who so carefully and calculated makes that catch first down.
Well, it was a nice job of Skylar Howard moving in the pocket. You're going to see him as he drops back. He's just going to slide a little bit to his right once he goes through his progressions, and it actually helped open up a throwing lane for him. He only stands at 6 feet tall, so he's got to be able to move between the offensive linemen to find throwing lanes.
Play action and an end zone shot. Durant it and got his foot in. Touchdown, West Virginia. Boy, does that feel good for Javon Durant, who was undressed by Dana Holgorsen just a minute ago.
The fastest wide receiver on the West Virginia offense. Javon Durant's going to run a bit of a double move as you see him lean inside and get back to the outside. And indeed, Durant's able to possess the football and get 1 foot down in the back of the end zone. And that's a great play considering you're going against Morgan Burns, who's the best cornerback on Kansas State.
Durant already with his third catch of the game. He had three catches over the previous six. Extra point from Josh Lambert. Under the hold of Nick O'Toole, and West Virginia the first to find the end zone. They do it on an impressive throw from Howard to the freshman Javon Durant, who has had a roller coaster freshman season, trying to finish the regular season in style. FS1 College Football is presented by K Jewelers, back in Manhattan. Sun setting, temperature in the low 50s. This is the latest, as far as the calendar goes, that K-State has played a game in Manhattan since 1896, when they played that powerhouse Fort Riley to a 6-6 tie. Let's go down to Chris Budden.
Joe Hogerson and Durant have now hugged and made up. As you said, he was ripping into him earlier when he went over to his wide receivers. He said, it's time for you guys to grow up. I need one of you to act like a Division I football player. But he's now in a little bit better mood.
Wow.
But that's part of the frustration for Dana Holgorsen, is he sees the potential in his wide receivers and in some of his playmakers. And when they don't do it on a consistent basis, or you see it in practice but you don't see it translate to the game, that's the hardest thing for a coach, because you're figuring out how to push these guys and how to reach the top of their ability.
I'm just glad we haven't had to remind Chris to act like a Division I reporter this year. We've done that without us even prompting. The 25-yard line, they bubble it outside and off of the hands of Delvin Wormack. A couple of timeouts for K-State, but they've not shown the ability to move. Only 112 yards. They say that was a forward pass. It was pretty close.
We're going to have a pretty good look right here, and that, I would say, is indeed forward.
Yeah. Left his hand at the 19. And
beautiful follow through by Huebner.
Yeah. Incomplete over the head of Burton, who is well defended by Kwiatkowski. Third down.
Huebner was trying to wait for him to clear through that window behind K.J. Dillon, but then there awaited Nick Kwiatkowski, who was actually recruited to West Virginia to play safety and has since converted to a linebacker. But you can see he's got very, very solid cover skills.
And on his way to leading this team in tackles for a third consecutive season. Third down and 10. All 11 men stand, and then 8 drop. Huebner off his back foot, incomplete. Cody Cook, the intended receiver, and this West Virginia defense has Joe Huebner feeling uncomfortable right now.
Yeah, it's in part because of how they disguise some of their pressures. Look at all the guys up around the line of scrimmage. Joe Huebner's saying, all right, I got to change this. I got to bring someone in to help out with protection. Then West Virginia changes. They only end up rushing 3, drop 8 into coverage, but by that time, you've already changed your protection. Now you've got a bad play versus a good defense for West Virginia. That's the cat and mouse game they're playing.
In a crowd, Dillon lucky that it didn't hit one of his blockers. West Virginia's already fumbled once on a punt return today. They dodge a bit of a bullet there and have it at the 37. 23 runs, 19 passes today. Here's another run to Shell, who smartly races for the sideline.
There you go, just when you think they're going to open
Maybe
it up.
Not.
This air raid offense, no, it's right back to the ground, and Russell Shell wisely gets out of bounds.
Preserve those 2 timeouts, second down and 5. Shell motions out. Howard comes across, throws to the middle, and it's caught by Thompson, who's having a great first half. It's his 4th catch already.
And that was a great catch. It's hard to tell without being able to take a look back at it, but he really concentrated and focused on the ball into his hands as he secured it going to the ground.
Big hole for Shell. Good block by Thompson. First down to the 25. Jackson with the tackle after 19 yards.
When you play this fast like West Virginia, you can still run the football because you can hit some home runs. When you have a guy like Wendell Smallwood and Russell Shell in your backfield, you can take advantage of still being a balanced offense.
Smallwood is back in there. Howard tucks it and gets 4. Bryant and Britt combine it in the tackle. And they use a timeout back in 30 seconds for the final 21 seconds of this first half. Take a look at the comparison on the ground for these two teams. Both of them run oriented. West Virginia's over 100 yards. Wendell Smallwood already 75. They've marched it down the field with the exception of one play, all on the ground on this drive that started with about a minute. Still one timeout to work with. They fake the run and throw it underneath to Dakeel Shorts for a first down. First down and goal to the 9. With 14 ticks remaining.
And the biggest key is getting up to the line of scrimmage, getting the play called, so once they are set to run the clock, you're snapping the football and there's no wasted time.
They did that to perfection. Smallwood bounces off the penetration. Poor tackling allows him to spring to the 1. Got 8 yards, and West Virginia will use that final timeout with 5 seconds.
Well, the junior out of Wilmington, Delaware, is so tough to bring down because he can get skinny in a heartbeat. First off, he's able to use a stiff arm to get away from Gary, then splits 2 defenders to get up close to the goal line.
Little chip shot, but like you said, from a tough angle for a right-footed kicker. Got it. So they do capitalize on this final drive of the first half and take a 13-3 lead, right, in a 4-game winning streak after starting Big 12 play 0-4. Try to finish the regular season on a 5-game run.
And if you're K-State on senior day, you got to find a way right now to go inside that locker room, make some adjustments, make some changes, and be able to come out in the second half, put some points on the scoreboard, because you're going to be getting the ball first.
Chris Button is with Coach Holgorsen.
Well, Coach, we saw you challenge your offense, and they've stepped up those last few drives. What's been the difference with them?
Well, it wasn't just the whole offense. You know, we're playing pretty good up front. I think our backs are playing really well. Skyler's managing it okay. Inside receivers playing well. The wideouts aren't playing very good. We got to make plays downfield when they take away the run.
For Skyler, we saw him take some hits running to the locker room real fast. How's his health?
Oh, he's good. He's good. You know, he kind of got twisted up there, but then he came sprinting out of the tunnel, so I knew he was good.
Appreciate it. Good luck in the second half. Joe?
Thank you, Coach. Thank you, Chris. Right now, we send it to Mike Kill in Los Angeles after the first half here in Manhattan. See what's going on so far. We welcome you back inside. Joe Davis, Brady Quinn. It was a 3-3 game. Nobody doing anything. Then West Virginia got a little help from the defense. Got it going. Got scores on their last 2 possessions.
Yeah, really, West Virginia had some missed opportunities earlier in the day, but then they began to find their rhythm through a couple turnovers. Their defense kind of bailing them out, and that's what they've done best all year long. Has been ball hawks in the back end making plays, and their offense capitalized. A big play here to Javon Duran as Burns gets burnt for the touchdown. Then the running game came into play. Marshall Shell, Wendell Smallwood, big gains that got them down around the goal line and really allowed them to get some field goals. So that's been the story of the game so far. We'll see if West Virginia can continue to capitalize.
K-State will have it to begin the second half. Morgan Burns with some room, and Morgan Burns down the sideline, makes a cut, accelerates inside the 40. He's been doing it all season.
The Big 12 Special Teams Player of the Week for 3 weeks in a row. I mean, this guy is sensational in the return game. He's just, you can't prepare for him. Kent State does a good job blocking downfield, but it's the speed and the vision of Burns to be able to navigate all the chaos in front of him and make big plays and provide the Kansas State offense with good field position.
He's taken 3 back for touchdowns this season, 4 in his career. Runs this one back to the 33, and that's where Joe Huebner, this K-State offense, go to work trying to turn things around. Pumps left, runs straight ahead. and pays the price after four. Shaq Pettaway with the tackle. Chris Button, you talked to Coach Snyder.
I did, and he was rather simplistic when I asked him about his offense and what they needed to do. He said, we need to block, we need to get people open, and we need to catch the football. So, Brady, you know, it's as simple as that. He also said, we need to play a lot better than we're playing right now if this thing's going to turn around.
Yeah, right now, Joe Huebner on the ground, clearly in pain, looking at that right leg.
But as he broke through the line of scrimmage, Shaq Pettaway kind of came in and got him low, and then you see Nick Kwiatkowski coming in and finish him off up top.
The backup quarterback is the receiver, their leading receiver, Cody Cook. Good to see Huebner walking off under his own power. But it's Cody Cook, senior out of Lewisburg, Kansas, into the game with a second down and six on K-State's first possession of the second.
What you're going to see out of the Kansas State offense with Cody Cook at the helm is a lot more running at the quarterback position, but not necessarily more so than what Joe Huebner did, but different types of runs. More to the outside where he doesn't have to go through a lot of the defensive linemen and some of the bangers on the inside of West Virginia's defense.
So Cody Cook, his first snap at quarterback today. See how long it takes Tony Gibson to try to heat him up. They bring Andre Davis in tighter to the formation. And they bring heat right away. Cody Cook gets rid of it. And it's Klein, first down inside the 15.
Absolutely sensational from Kyle Klein, the senior out of Loveland, Colorado. They heat up Cody Cook right away. But Cook hangs in there, navigates the pocket, finds the soft spot, and gets the ball to Klein just outside of the reach of K.J. Dillon. You know, that's one of the toughest things. When you come as a backup, you don't get many reps during the week, and all of a sudden, you have to handle all the communication with your wide receivers and offensive line. Sometimes that's the toughest part.
Both fullbacks in the game. Cook behind Dibble. Inside the 10. Nice first down gain of about four. Brown and Askew Henry combined on the tackle. It's second down.
Again, you got to run with Cody Cook on the outside. You can't subject him to more of those hits. And you look after Cody Cook, and you're talking about redshirt freshman Zach Davidson, who they don't necessarily want to put in the ball game unless they have to at this point.
Cook was a high school quarterback, played quarterback at the junior college level, and has played some of it here at K-State. Trying to get him back to within a score. The play clock winding down, and he's making changes still. Barely got it off. Sticks his nose down. Powers his way. First down and goal. Cook providing the spark for Kansas State.
Well, Cody Cook tried to remain patient, but watch this. He actually gets ahead of his fullback. I don't know if there's a miscommunication, but clearly it was a run play, and not everyone was on the same page as Cody Cook changed the play at the last minute. Look at him running tough, though, putting his shoulder down. He only stands 6'1", 200 pounds, but just a tough player.
Here's the old T formation. They try to sneak it in. No signal yet. Uncover that pile. He's in. Touchdown, Kansas State, and Cody Cook.
Well, he provided a spark earlier in the season for Kansas State when he ended the game. He talked about his performance versus Oklahoma State, but watch the push of the offensive line. None of us, the fullbacks in behind him. You know, this used to be illegal a number of years ago. Back when I played, you couldn't push the ball carrier forward, but they've since changed the rule, and this is part of the strategy now. You can utilize those quarterback sneaks up around the line of scrimmage. And
right, sorry to bring it up, but just turn the
page,
there.
I'll turn the page.
Cody Cook, just what the doctor ordered. Patterson to Shelton Gibson, who's taken one back for a touchdown this season. Gibson exploding and flying his way into the 35, where he's cut down by the kicker. Patterson, first down from the 38-yard line for West Virginia. Their first play of the second half is an incomplete pass to Russell Shell, second and 10.
frustrating thing about the West Virginia passing game. You see flashes of what it's capable of, but they just don't do it consistently enough.
It has bothered Dana Holgorsen to no end.
Time, nowhere to go for Skylar Howard.
Fourth Kansas State sack of the game. Third down and 17 in this place, and the blink of an eye has come alive. Howard on time. Thompson has it knocked away by Nate Jackson. So a big special teams play to begin the half, then a touchdown, and then a three and out forced by the D.
All three phases doing exactly what head coach Bill Snyder talked about at halftime. Coming up, making big plays. As you see, Nate Jackson, the safety, coming up on Jordan Thompson, had a big first half, but that's going to be a key. Nate Jackson, Kendall Adams, they've got to step up their play at the safety position for the Kansas State defense.
O'Toole has averaged more than 50 yards a pop. Punting today. Muldrow hit that first at the 25, so that's where it will be spotted. Kansas State trying to finish the regular season with a third consecutive win to become bowl eligible despite a six-game losing streak at one point this season. 13-10 early third. Cody Cook back in there for his second drive after Joe Huebner was injured. Completed the only pass that he threw. With a nice run to set up first down and goal, then snuck it in for K-State's first touchdown. The first touchdown against this West Virginia defense in 11 quarters. Play action on first down. Heaving the ball deep, he's got Burton in stride. Deontay Burton is inside the five. They'll say that he's in. Touchdown, Kansas State from 78 yards.
Is an absolute gamer. Just comes in, dropping dimes, making plays with his feet. He's a three-man route combination where they essentially clear it all out. And he's gonna see the coverage deep over the top. See the play action fake, hoping to hold the linebackers for a little bit, but Deontay Burton turns on the afterburners and absolutely blows by the West Virginia secondary.
I think he's in. Good job by that crew who couldn't quite keep up with Deontay Burton, but still got the call right despite not having a true angle at this.
There's no doubt in my mind he was able to reach the ball across the plane or across the goal line.
We'll be honest, you and I were talking at halftime, man, watching this K-State offense, not sure they can even overcome this 10-point deficit, but here we are.
Back with the lead now.
Yeah. 17-13, Deontay Burton. On the bomb from Cody Cook, K-State in front for the first time. FS1 College Football is presented by K Jewelers.
Where it seemed like in the first half, the K-State offense couldn't get anything together. Cook providing the spark.
They keep it away from Shelton Gibson. Up to get it is Gary Jennings, who has a seam. And Gary Jennings with a big play on special teams into Kansas State territory. So they successfully keep it from Gibson, but Jennings takes it back 52 yards. They'll run it again. Mike UL Moore with another tackle. Kendall Adams there as well. But he got five more and now has exactly 100 yards tonight.
Sure, Mike UL Moore looks banged up. Still down on the ground. Not a lot of drop off necessarily going to Will Davis, but Shemaiku Elmore is having one heck of a game. You'd like to see him be able to get back in there.
You mentioned the recent stretch he's having. 27 tackles in the last three games for Moore. Second down and four. Edge pressure coming. Howard gets rid of it. Throws it high. Knew he was going to have one-on-one and went for DeKeel Shorts. Kendall Adams covered him well. Third and four.
Well, the Kansas State defense did a good job disguising. They waited till almost the snap to pull off the blitz. And Skylar Howard just really never settled his feet. Looked a little bit uncomfortable. Therein lies the inaccurate football.
Underneath, Shorts has a first down. A guy that Dana Holgorsen says is as reliable as any receiver he's ever been around. He's got 10 yards and a West Virginia first down.
Yeah, he's not the fastest guy, but he's very quick and elusive in small spaces.
Smallwood for three as West Virginia again really starts picking up that tempo.
Had a lot of success with the runs to the outside. We talked about it earlier in the game. The wide receivers for West Virginia do a really good job blocking on the outside and forcing the Kansas State safeties to be the only one to make a tackle in space.
Again, it's shorts. And he sets up a third down and short. We mentioned in the first half how big Adam Pankey's return was for this offense. Pankey is not in there. Stone Underwood is back in at left guard.
The fifth-year senior out of Brookhaven, Massachusetts, excuse me, Mississippi, but played a little bit last week.
Shorts again, feeding him on this drive inside the 15, first down.
And what you're seeing is a lot of quick throws to shorts and the slot wide receiver, and they keep going back to the same play, just different formations or flipping the formation.
Shorts third catch on this drive from the 14-yard line. First down and 10, West Virginia trying to jump back in front. Smallwood explodes for the touchdown. Wendell Smallwood in from 14 yards, and West Virginia goes back in front here in the third quarter.
Well, Skylar Howard was able to change the play, but watch Jordan Thompson. He's going to set the block that allows Smallwood to cut back up inside, eventually burst in the end zone. These West Virginia wide receivers are very selfless in their job of blocking the outside and helping out their teammate, Wendell Smallwood,
whose career high is 24 carries. He's got 19 now. Five times in his career, he's gone above 20, but never 25. Dan Holgorsen told us this week they've been hesitant to because he's as valuable as he is. They didn't want to wear him down. They've got a long break coming before the bowl game, so they're going to ride him as long as they need to. They ride him back into the lead, 20-17 West Virginia. Smallwood and Shorts had all the yards on that drive as West Virginia got that three and out defensively and then marched down the field to retake the lead. Morgan Burns had a big return to open the second half. Hesitates, cuts back, has room. One of the only men faster than Morgan Burns is Shelton Gibson, and he raced after him to bring him down after 37.
I can't get over how special Morgan Burns is. Watch him field the punt. He starts to bring the return to the right where all his blocking set up. Kind of stalls out. Nothing's there. But again, has the vision to see the green space that he can run to and has the speed to be able to almost get to the outside. Just a special, special player. You'd have to believe he'd be again the special teams Big 12 player of the week, considering there's only a number of games this week.
Since only two.
There's only two. From. So I would think he'd win it again for a fourth consecutive week.
I wonder if they give one away this week. Only two games.
Why not? Why give not? It to the guy.
Yeah. Even if you don't usually just do it. Silman on first down, not much there. Eric Kinsey, contributor all 4 years on that D-line, makes the stop. Second down and 9. Cody Cook in the game because Joe Huebner is out with a leg injury. No, Chris Budden reporting that he looks like he's ready to come back in. Why pull the hot hand, though?
And all the changes at quarterback this season for Kansas State. Jesse Ertz started the season, got hurt in that first game. Alex Denton, he was injured. Jonathan Bangs had a sickness. He's getting redshirted.
Silman, Barber there to shut him down. Up from the secondary to help is Jeremy Tyler. K.J. Dillon involved as well. His West Virginia defense went 12 quarters in a row without giving up a touchdown. Got to go back to the third quarter of the Texas game before Cody Cook arrived and produced two in a four-minute stretch.
Well, that's the hard part for Tony Gibson, is he's got to prepare for a player that he really hasn't seen since the earlier part of this year. All his game plan's been for Joe Huebner. Now we got Cody Cook in. Whole different ball game.
Cook had a short touchdown run and a quarterback sneak, then a long touchdown throw to Deontay Burton against pressure, zipping incomplete. No flag. Looked like Worley maybe got there a touch early against Burton. Fourth down.
You know, he's Tony Gibson's going up against a different quarterback with his game plan, but one thing that's consistent is the pressure. Well, let's take a look at the coverage on the outside as it appears if Daryl Worley got there too early, and indeed he did. Officials didn't think that, see, that was the time frame at which you'd call pass interference, but I don't know. Worley a little bit too early.
Good punt here. Durant awkwardly catches it, makes the first man miss. Back to the 15. Play action for Howard, who's taking a shot. Thompson running by the defense. And he makes a contested catch. 51 yards. What a play by the senior Thompson.
And he's just had a phenomenal night. Watch as he climbs up on Kendall Adams. Howard throws a ball that allows Thompson an opportunity, and Thompson with a strong hands to come away with the football.
Season high, 127 yards for Jordan Thompson. Bringing this third quarter to a close in a three-point game. This is what we showed up for, some excitement. Wasn't much of it in the first half. Third quarter was loaded with it. What will the fourth quarter bring in the final game of the Big 12 season? Who's ready for the fourth quarter? In a tight one in Manhattan. First down and 10 from the 29. Skyler Howard throwing the corner route. Incomplete. Good break in the ball by Nate Jackson. With a pass intended for Jordan Thompson. Second and 10.
The West Virginia offense has run this concept a number of times. That's why Nate Jackson's a smart player. He's able to identify it, get a good break on the football, and almost come away with the interception.
Smallwood trying to get outside, stepped out of an ankle tackle, ran over a defender, and got seven or eight.
This is where he has the majority of his production. It's Wendell Smallwood, when he gets outside, he utilizes that speed and then lowers his shoulder.
On Morgan Burns, third down and two. He'll throw it. Shorts has it for a first down. A little surprising that they put it in the air. Donnie Starks with the tackle. First down, West Virginia.
They've run this concept a number of times. It's a corner, a little sit route, a little sit route. And they keep hitting shorts, or they'll take a shot over top to Jordan Thompson on that corner route.
Smallwood downhill. Moore is back in the game getting another tackle. 6 yards.
And then they come back with the exact same run play they had two plays ago. I mean, that's the thing about this offense is it's simplified. They run what works because they're able to practice it that much more during the week as opposed to having 150 plays that you only get through once.
Just a lot of window dressing, a lot of different formations that those core plays come from. Second down and 5. Play action, floating, end zone, shorts. Can't get it. Burns hip to hip, third down.
And that went right through the breadbasket of Schwartz. Had an opportunity in the corner. Howard gave him a chance. You see Nate Jackson getting up in the face of Howard, but watch this ball go right through his arms. Now, it would have been tough to still get a foot in bounds.
Big play here as Kansas State tries to force the field goal to keep it a one-score game. Sean Blitz. Howard. Kendall Adams brought him down. And they do indeed stop him. Field goal team not coming out yet. You'd assume they're gonna, and here they come.
Yeah, that was an interesting play call on Dana Holgerson. I would have think you're gonna throw the football at least into the end zone at that point. If you don't get it, then you still fall back on the field goal, but. Usually you'd run the football there if you thought this was two down territory.
Lambert good today from 45 and from 19. He missed from 44. This from 28. Right down the middle. And West Virginia back in front by 6. Early on fourth quarter, Manhattan. Got a good one going.
The Mountaineer mascot first appeared at WVU sport events in 1934 and 35. school year. Lawson Hill taking on the role. The Mountaineer is selected each year by the Mountain Honoree, the school's prestigious senior honoree. Costumes tailored with a rifle and a coonskin cap.
Morgan Burns will have a chance to return this. And Burns with room. Morgan Burns breaking free. Morgan Burns has done it again. No flags.
I would say it's safe to say he gets that special team play of the week for another week in the Big 12. Morgan Burns, who's been as big of a part of this two-game win streak as any player for Kansas State, again, finds the hole in the return coverage and then just blows away the West Virginia defense. I mean, it's unbelievable. He's done this week after week after week. Why do you still kick to him?
Yeah. Extra point is a big one, and it puts Kansas State back in front. Yeah, I don't know if they give one away in a week where there's only two games, but whether or not they do, they need to just
they
make
should
one up
invent
and get to
one then for this young man, yeah, with the way he's played here on senior day.
His fourth kickoff return touchdown this season ties him for the single season record, fifth in his career.
He's a deflected punt earlier after a recovery for a touchdown last week. Now we've got a number of returns, big returns, helping to set up Kansas State really in good field position. And it hasn't necessarily been all the blocking downfield. It's actually been his creativity and his ability to kind of see where there's green grass and then the speed to get there. Just sensational the way Morgan Burns has been able to turn the momentum in games during this two-game win streak, really all year long.
We've talked about Cody Cook and what he did to spark that first drive of the second half. But remember, what really woke this place up and seemingly woke this team up was his long return to open the second half.
Yeah, I mean, clearly whatever was said in the locker room in Kansas State during halftime is hitting home and resonating with all the players.
And this kick bounces into the end zone for a touchback. Down one. 9:34 to go. Howard well protected on first down. Got rid of it and found a tight window. Hey, remember Kevin White last year? That's his little brother, Karan. First catch in three games, first down to the 45.
He's been battling an ankle injury and has found his way back into the lineup now that he's healthy. But really, they've been rotating this wide receiver group because they haven't found consistent production out of any one player.
Maybe incredible, talking about the resilience of this Kansas State team to be able to fight back and finish the season strong.
Smallwood across the 40, still all three timeouts for West Virginia, so their full playbook at their disposal here. Oh man, this one's blown up. Guess who? Sure, Mike UL Moore.
This might be one of the first negative runs Smallwood's had all night, but sure, Mike UL Moore just blows by Stone Underwood at the left guard position. We talked about before that factor, Underwood not being as good as Adam Pankey, who was in earlier in the game but taken out.
Third down and 10, over the middle. Durant has it, but short. Make that shorts to kill shorts, and it's fourth down and a long one. Offense stays on the field. Fourth down and one with 2:40.
This is a gutsy call considering how well your defense has played as of late. Right there is to kill shorts. That's where you'd like to work, but it looks like they're going to run this football.
Howard trying to get outside. Sir Mike UL Moore, his 17th tackle of the night, the biggest yet.
And he has just been all over the field all night long.
The junior out of Dallas, Texas, Skyline High School, has been sensational. Watch him track the quarterback. He's not fooled at all by the fake by Skylar Howard. And the closing speed and the ability to bring down Howard for the turnover on downs. A huge stop for the Kansas State defense. And now an opportunity for Kansas State to try to run the clock out. And you better believe this is one of the better teams in the country at milking the clock and taking up some of that time of possession.
Second time we've seen West Virginia go to that similar play, trying to get Howard outside in a short yardage situation tonight. Same result. So from the 46, all three timeouts still for West Virginia. Bringing pressure. Cook. Pounded by Jeremy Tyler after two.
When you have a quarterback who can run the football, that's essentially going to be the guy who's going to be unaccounted for is Jeremy Tyler, the free safety. He's the guy who's going to be responsible for coming up and making tackles on the quarterback.
First timeout used by West Virginia, still two left. 2:21 to go. Riding a four-game winning streak into this one after they lost four in a row to begin Big 12 play.
It's Morgan Burns, who's had one heck of a night again. The fire starter in special teams for Kansas State, who's been absolutely sensational for the past 4 weeks now.
Yeah. His kick return touchdown, the difference right now in a one-point game. Cook with another short gain. Kyle Rose the tackle. Timeout number two for West Virginia. Third down and seven. Kansas State trying to make that a moot point. Cook to throw. Zips one for Burton. First down inside the 30. You said it earlier. Cody Cook, gamer.
Just a smooth operator. I mean, watch as he stands there with all the bodies up around the line of scrimmage. And Deontay Burton, he's come up with big plays for this offense in the passing game time after time tonight. Five catches for 135 yards and a touchdown.
I can't believe they threw it. Four for 11 now is Cook. 144 and just one timeout for West Virginia. Charles Jones to the 25. Inside of a minute and a half, Dana Holgorsen still holding on to that final timeout. Career high 135 yards for Burton, who's had best season of his career here as a junior.
And this is really comes down to your offensive line. It's a very experienced group. It's got four seniors across the starting five. The center, Dalton Reisner, is a redshirt freshman, but these are the guys you're going to want to hang your hat on and try to come away with a win and by running out the clock.
Jones is stopped. They'll use that timeout now with 53 seconds, and if they're going to have any kind of shot, it's going to be a very, very small one.
West Virginia takes his third and final timeout of the half.
And they're going to need a pretty quick spot for this not to end it. Jones is stopped. Now they'll hurry off of him. Do you kick a field goal? What do you do here on fourth down?
There's about 6 seconds, yep. 5 seconds difference between the play clock and the game clock. And what I think you should do is you put Cody Cook back in shotgun. You allow him to roll out and throw a high arcing pass out of bounds. You have a wide receiver basically run towards the back of the end zone, and you essentially throw the football away. But you don't want to risk any sort of special teams play, whether that's a field goal or a punt or anything like that. Obviously not a punt this close, but I don't necessarily know if they're going to go with that route, but that would be one thing that you see a lot of teams do at times, to try to waste time on the clock and finish the game with the ball in their hands.
Kansas State.
Now there should be more than four
seconds.
Yeah.
To 7 seconds.
Oh wow.
Yeah, 7 seconds. They're gonna put it back. It'd be 7 seconds after this timeout.
Look, now that they have 7 seconds on the clock, that's an entirely different situation. But the way the college football season has been,
yeah.
I mean, we've seen some of the crazy special teams play. I mean, that's why Michigan State's in the position playing for the Big Ten Championship. And that big punt block versus Michigan gave them that game. And you just got to wonder right now if Kansas State wants to put their special teams in that position, and it doesn't appear so. let's expect them to find a way of shotgunning it back to Cook. He'll try to waste some time, and if not running, he'll find a way to heave the ball downfield. It looks like Deontay Burton. All the way on the outside, I'd release him downfield and just throw up a pop-up to him that goes out of bounds. Burton at the top of the screen.
All right, so that's what they're going to do. He's going to roll, waste as much time as he can, heave it up and out of bounds with a hometown clock operator and no time left. It was borderline. Should there be zero or one? And Bill Snyder knows that this may not be finished yet. If the replay booth thinks there should be a second put back, Mike DeFee, our head referee, telling the teams head back to the sideline. Many of the West Virginia players are heading to the locker room already. All right, so we will get one last prayer for West Virginia. The craziest of college football seasons, the final Saturday for most teams of the regular season.
What you're going to see is basically West Virginia trying to pitch the ball around and lateral it until they can find their way down into the end zone. And again, I referenced that Miami Duke game earlier in the season where Duke was able to do that in order to get a win. It's tough, especially, you know, sometimes you see teams substitute skill players for their offensive line because usually they get the ball out so quick. You want to have faster guys or more faster guys on the field. It's the difference between that Miami return when it was on a kickoff return, yep, as opposed to this play.
Here you go. Last play, barring a penalty. Howard heaves it up. Broken up. That does it. Lonnie Gibson, Elijah Lee knocked it away. Now West Virginia can go to the locker room. 24-23, the final. And Kansas State follows a six-game losing streak with a three-game run to become bowl eligible for Bill Snyder. Questions always swirling about his future. He's remained silent about what that future will hold.
An absolutely incredible career to a coach who is really the orchestrator of the greatest turnaround in college football history here at Kansas State.
That does it for us here in Manhattan. By the way, Big Ten Championship just kicked off on Fox. I know we got to hustle to a TV to watch that. If you want hoops, stick around here after a short break. We've got that for you on FS1. 24-23, the final score in Manhattan. Kansas State on a kick return touchdown beats West Virginia.